Yes, well, I'll answer right now. Yes, of course I'm listening. And are we going to put it in a week from tonight? No, we're not. We've told you already that the advertising period has been extended to Christmas Eve. This has got to be properly considered by either the Cabinet, or the whole Cabinet, or the Cabinet member themselves, which is not going to happen then until the new year. So that decision has still got to be made. They have got to consider all the objections that have been made. So all objections that you make from this town have got to be looked at in order for the Cabinet to make any decision after the closing period for the traffic on the road.
Cassa?
You say that you're £100,000 shy for the South Hams enforcement officers, was that correct? About that, yeah? You're going to make somewhere in the order of £400,000 out of Dartmouth alone. I think that would more than make up for that. That money is coming out of everybody's pockets. Everybody's pockets. It's money that can't be spent in the pubs, can't be spent in the restaurants, can't be spent in the shops, and comes out of people's food bills. It's simply not on.
John.
Oh, hi.
Oh, sorry, Steve.
Steve Smith, local councillor, concerned councillor. We've drifted off the subject too much, but the reason why we're bankrupt is because we bailed out the banks, but that's a different subject. My mind goes back to a letter that John Hart wrote. In his statement, he actually put that, if I can remember what it says that there would be no public consultation on the subject of pay and display because it would slow down the process of implementation. That's what it said. And he's actually the main guy in the Cabinet. The older I get, the more cynical I get, and I'm beginning to think this is just a tick-the-box exercise, and, okay, we're very grateful that Leicester is here. We're grateful it's extended to Christmas Eve, happy Christmas. However, I just have the sneaky feeling that we've ticked the boxes, and it's going to happen anyway. And if that's the case, what we should be now saying is this whole idea of a half an hour is totally out of the question. There is not a lot you can do in half an hour. An hour is reasonable, even if we've got to accept it. Because what's going to happen then, we've got two major supermarkets on the estate. Local businesses are on their knees in this town. The longer this goes on for, they will be on their backs. And we need to seriously think about this. Dartmouth is a unique case, and we need to fight for it.
John, can we have the lady with the woolly hat? Please. Sorry.
I live in Bucktown. There's 145 houses up there. Only a third are occupied by full-time residents. Where are we to park? People are leaving our road. We can't go down much lower in occupancy. Where are we to park? I regularly park a mile from my home on a daily basis. Where am I to go now? I will leave the town. And a lot of our residents feel the same along the town. We can't even get... Well, true, but can we afford to stay? I mean, we can't even... Excuse me, let me make my point. We have got a road where modern emergency ambulance cannot even get along the road. We've been told if we need to get to hospital, we need access to our car. Where are we to park? You have taken 125 parking spaces that I rely on September to May, and you have made it 2 hours. That's the point.
You're talking about the embankment.
No. Mayor's Avenue, Higher Street, Lower Street, Oxford Street, Hawley Street, College Way. All those places I can currently park on in October 1st.
We've already got the...
No, two places have no restriction, and that's Higher Street and Oxford Street. All the other streets, it is May to September. That's 5 months of the year.
We've got the guarantee here from Leicester this evening, and I'm sure he'll take it back and confirm it with us, that there will be no further restrictions than already is in place.
124 places currently.
So I'm sure Leicester will get back to us on that.
Can I just make the point then that some of your colleagues have privately stated that the reason the residence permits are not looked at favourably is they're not economically viable. There's no money in residence permits.
Well, I'm afraid they're probably right, but that's not the reason that the residence parking scheme couldn't work in Dartmouth. You know, the residence parking permits in the county at the moment cost £20, wherever you are in the county. Just in terms of administering that process, it costs about £20. There isn't any money in that. And on top of that, there is the need for enforcement. These things don't work unless they're enforced, whether we like that or not. That you have to have effective enforcement. And that goes for residence parking schemes and normal waiting restrictions, as well as full waiting restrictions like no waiting at any time restrictions. They've got to be enforced because they're there for a reason. If they're not there, they're not needed, then what we should be doing is taking them away.
Does the county appreciate that the PB report suggested that the town needed an additional 200 odd spaces for it to function?
That's what the PB report suggested, yes, but I don't know where the county council would find 200 spaces from. But as I said,
that proves that we're trying to squeeze court into a pint pot. We always have been with traffic here, haven't we?
Okay, listen, I don't want to quote back things that have been said earlier on, but you know, there was an assertion earlier on that this doesn't improve anything, and I think
that would be roundly supported by the room. But then I hear that parking works tolerably well. Well, if that's the case, we're not changing anything, really. We're just...
Yes, you are. Yes, you are.
What you are obviously changing is imposing on the people who are here long-term a hideously expensive cost on putting their car anywhere near their house.
Yeah, right. Yes.
We could all buy a car for less than the cost of this per year, couldn't we?
But the restrictions are there during the daytime at the moment, between 9 and 6. You can't park a car there leaving for more than 1 hour or 2 hours as it is.
It's free!
Okay. Please don't keep repeating what we all know, please.
Last question.
Can we have one more question? Because there's a lot of people here that haven't had any questions.
Just one last question. For the avoidance of doubt, can you verify that the meters have not yet been ordered?
No, I can't. I can confirm that they have been ordered.
Can I just ask then, if they have been ordered, to what do you refer to when you refer to a consultation?
Where is democracy?
If you're not happy, then please leave the room. We are here to try and listen and help, I assure you. Please. Okay, that's.
You can see from their actions that they're quite concerned that the consultation period means perhaps more dictation than consultation.
Absolutely. Waste of time.
Joe, okay. Can we have the gentleman with the beard?
Who's got a beard?
And then we'll try and wind up. Gentlemen?
Good evening. My name's Owen Hill. I'm a solicitor in the town. I have to say I began this evening with some sympathy for the officer having to take flak on behalf of the decision makers of the County Council, but during the course of the evening that sympathy has not dissipated. I did expect the briefing to be adequate. I did expect there to be an understanding as to the nature of the changes that were being imposed. I was very frustrated by the dialogue earlier that seemed to suggest it was all about the mechanics of policing to our patches, which it clearly isn't. The much stronger feeling in the room relates to the release of out-of-season restrictions on the on the riverside and other areas that have been posed with restrictions that have previously been unrestricted. I have to say that the admission that the meetings have been ordered shows such a disrespect by the County Council for the process that I believe that if action were taken to ask for a judicial review of this, the decision will be overturned and the proceedings will be started again.
Now, is there anybody else that hasn't spoken?
My name is John Mitchell. I am a resident here. I just want to understand the democratic process within the Devon County Council. I mean, who actually makes this decision? How many people?
There's nine on the cabinet.
And how many from that cabinet are in the town?
I'm not 100% certain. I know there's one, which is Councillor Stuart Hughes, who is the lead officer, the lead councillor for this. What was interesting, 6 months ago, Sidmouth was not one of those originally four towns that was being proposed. And I have to admit, he has now got his head above the parapet, and he's now one of those eight, which I'm absolutely delighted at.
I would agree with you. I would agree with you entirely.
And the other thing I wanted to say, I don't think it's up to us to show the opposition. I think we've shown an awful lot of opposition now. I would like to think that the best way out of all this is for nothing to be done until the burnt-out buildings are then reinstated, and then perhaps we can come back. See how the town is and has suffered during that time, and look at it again.
And the people who have gone in the back, we have to be very careful of how we present our case. We do know the country's in a terrible state, and people do need money. It's no good us hiding away. At 3 o'clock this afternoon, and I'm quite happy to tell you all now, I had a phone call officially, Dartmouth Police Station is closing. Another nail in the coffin of this town. And it's not gossip, it was from the Chief Constable, it's happening, and Kingsbridge as well. Now, if we're going to fight this case, you can argue, and I've done more work than I would care to admit on this, but there are towns where parking meters as part of a traffic strategy has been a benefit to that town, but they will lack other places where they can park their cars. And Dartmouth has not got that
luxury. The idea of tonight's meeting was to try and make clear for views of Dartmouth to Devon County Council and the Cabinet members. Dartmouth is very much opposed, as am I, about the pay and display options for Dartmouth. There are a number of issues for that. The huge increases in business tax which we had in April, the devastating fire which we had in March, and also the topography of Dartmouth makes it very, very difficult for residents to find places to park. Pay and display, in my view, is a stealth tax, and I think at the present moment, with the way the economy is in Dartmouth, this is certainly not required.